Greetings, everyone there. It's Rob, the Ignorant Entrepreneur, and Google's DeepMind says it is close to achieving human-level artificial intelligence. The game is over. Now, DeepMind, a British company owned by Google, may be on the verge of achieving human-level artificial intelligence, or AI. Nando de Freitas, a research scientist at DeepMind and machine learning professor at Oxford University, has said the game is over. That's his words. And he's saying this in regards to solving the hardest challenges in the race to achieve artificial general intelligence, or AGI. Now, AGI refers to a machine or program that has the ability to understand or learn any intellectual task that a human being can and do so without training. According to De Freitas, the quest for scientists is now scaling up AI programs such as with more data and computing power to create an AGI. Now, earlier this past week, DeepMind unveiled a new AI agent called Gato that can complete 604 different tasks across a wide range of environments. Gato uses a single neural network, a computing system with interconnected nodes that work like nerve cells in the human brain. It can chat, caption images, stack blocks with a real robot arm, and even play the 1980s home video game console Atari. Now, even from what De Freitas was saying in his tweet, you know, about making these models bigger, safer, computing efficient, faster, he admitted that humanity is still far away from creating an AI that can pass the Turing test, which I don't know if you've ever seen that movie Ex Machina. It was pretty cool. It's a test of a machine's ability to exhibit intelligent behavior equivalent to or indistinguishable from that of a person. So after DeepMind's announcement of Gato, the Next Web article said it demonstrates AGI no more than virtual assistants such as Amazon's Alexa and Apple's Siri, which are already on the market and in people's homes. The Next Web contributor Tristan Green said, Gato's ability to perform multiple tasks is more like a video game console that can store 600 different games than it is like a game you could play 600 different ways. It's not general AI, it's a bunch of pre-trained narrow models bundled neatly. And Gato has been built to achieve a variety of 100 tasks, but this ability may compromise the quality of each task, according to other commentators. So yeah, this was a pretty short video, I know, but being that me and my partner Nick are in the space, I thought it was relevant to make a video about this. And also, there's just not been too many crazy stories about recently. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Are you into AI? Are you going to take a look at Gato? Let me know. But don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. This has been The Ignorant Entrepreneur. I'm out.